I believe some of the most prophetic words in the Brit Kaddishah, or New Covenant, are the opening comments of the Apostle John's Gospel, which states, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim, and the Word was Elohim. He was in the beginning with Elohim. All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made that was made. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." In these four short sentences, John captures the divine essence of who Yeshua truly is. And probably the most quoted biblical verse in history is John's 3:16. And it is through John that we have come to know from the book of Revelation that Yeshua is the Alpha and Omega, or in Hebrew, the Aleph and the Tav. There is no doubt that John had a way with words, and yet it is no mystery why he began his gospel with "in the beginning." Like a trail of breadcrumbs, John is leading us to Genesis 1:1 to prove his point from the Torah, that Yeshua was from the beginning with Father, and that all things were created through Him. And the placement of the Aleph Tav only substantiates His presence. But if you think that John builds his case only from Genesis 1:1, you would be missing the majority of the proof which John had to have seen. For Genesis 1:1 is where John only begins to build his case. The rest of the evidence is where the Aleph Tavs are located throughout the creation week, which proves that everything that was created by Father was both with and through Aleph Tav Yeshua. I write this in detail in the Aleph Tav Alert in the Messianic Aleph Tav Scriptures, in the first parashah in Genesis, which covers the creation. I actually found this when I was examining the placement of the Aleph Tavs during the creation week, and noticed there were Aleph Tavs placed by Moses during every day except on the third day. And as I began to investigate the Hebrew, the reasoning became crystal clear. When we hear about the creation week, we assume that something was actually created every day. But according to the Hebrew, this is not actually true. The word for create in Hebrew is bara, and the Hebrew word for made is asah. And every time one of these Hebrew words are used in the creation week, an Aleph Tav is used in the verse to confirm what John said, that everything was either made or created through Yeshua. And make no mistake, John had to have seen what I am about to show you, and it truly is amazing. Now, Moses sets the stage of the creation week, starting on the first day with Genesis 1:1. "In the beginning created bara Elohim Aleph Tav, the heavens, Aleph Tav, the earth." Verse 3, "And Elohim said, let there be light, and there was light. And saw Elohim, Aleph Tav, the light, that it was good." And then on the second day, Moses writes in verse 7, "And made, asah, Elohim, Aleph Tav, the firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament." Now skipping to the fourth day in verse 16, "And made, asah, Elohim, Aleph Tav, two great lights, the greater, Aleph Tav, light to rule the day, Aleph Tav, the lesser light to rule the night, Aleph Tav, the stars." Now on the fifth day in verse 21, "And created bara Elohim, Aleph Tav, sea creatures, great, Aleph Tav, every creature living that moves, which brought forth abundantly the waters after their kind, Aleph Tav, every kind of winged bird. And on the sixth day, we see in verse 25, and made Asa, Elohim, Aleph Tav, beast of the earth, after his kind, Aleph Tav, the cattle, after their kind, Aleph Tav, everything that crawls upon the earth. And Elohim saw that it was good. And Elohim said, let us make Asa, man, in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, the animals all over the earth, and every crawling creature that crawls upon the earth. So created Bara, Elohim, Aleph Tav, Adam, in his own image, in the image of Elohim, he created Bara, him. Moving down to verse 31, and saw Elohim, Aleph Tav, everything that he had made, Asa, and indeed it was good. Now let's look at the third day, starting in verse 9. And Elohim said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together in one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. And Elohim called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters he called seas. And Elohim saw that it was good. And Elohim said, let the earth put forth dashah, grass, seed-producing plants, and fruit trees, each yielding its own kind of seed-bearing fruit on the earth. And it was so. And the earth brought forth yatsa, grass, plants, each yielding its own kind of seed, and trees, each yielding its own kind of fruit. And Elohim saw that it was good, and there was evening and morning, day three. Notice the lack of the word create or made. The waters, which were already made on day one, were gathered together in one place, and the dry ground appeared. Now concerning the grass and the plants, the English word put forth in verse 11 is dashah, and the English word for brought forth in verse 12 in Hebrew is yatsah. And neither of these two Hebrew words have anything to do with creating or making anything. The Hebrew word dashah means to spring forth or sprout, and the Hebrew word yatsah means to break out. Consequently, nothing was created, and there are no Aleph Tavs on the third day. Now we see what John saw and why he proclaimed that everything that was made or created was made through Yeshua, because he knew Yeshua was the Aleph Tav. Yet in order for John to make this proclamation, it had to be confirmed in the Torah. John was simply connecting the dots in order to proclaim Yeshua's deity with the Father. I'm Bill Sanford, trying to put the Aleph Tav in proper perspective in our day. Shalom.